Hey guys, Don Maeda here. Trust me, it's me. You can't tell because the mask. But we're here at Perris Raceway for the launch of the 2021 KX250. Super excited about this. I'm joined by Ken Essex from Kawasaki. Dude, this thing is like radically changed from last year.
Yeah, big changes. It's an all new bike for 2021. You know, the 250 class is so competitive that we have to constantly be evolving and dedicated to performance. We've seen that, you know, obviously the Pro Circuit team is always making changes and evolving, and we see that trickle down to production. So all new for this year, we've got engine changes, chassis changes, a lot of the chassis swing arm come over from the 450, which you guys love. Of course, shootout winner. And we're looking to, you know, continue to build and bring that on down to the 250.
Okay, so last year was a completely new motor with the finger follower valve train system. I thought maybe, well, it's just the same motor in the 450 chassis, hydraulic clutch, and electric start.
Right.
But that's not the case. The motor has been improved.
That's it. So we made big changes, like you said, electric start, hydraulic clutch, first for 250. So these are, you know, first for Kawasaki. And yeah, you would think, you know, they made updates last year. Mm-hmm. That'll carry over. But again, this class is so competitive, you have to be on top of your game. And so we've been continuing to work. Japan's continuing to work and constantly tinkering. So we've made big changes. Piston's been updated. Connecting rod's been lengthened. Crankshaft's been revised to be lighter. Exhaust and intake porting has been revised as well. So all of that little changes transitions into big impact on the performance of the engine. Our rev range has increased. We're going up, rev up to 14.5 now. So 350 RPM more than last year. So you're really going to be able to hold every gear a little longer and really rev this thing out.
Okay, so the cone disc spring
in
the 450 made a huge difference, right? So in the past, I've put on like a recluse clutch, which has more plates and, you know, less slip down low.
Yep.
And for the 450, it made a big difference for us. It gave the feeling of more power down low because there's less clutch slip. It's been transitioned into the 250 as well now, right?
Correct. So you're really, with that cone disc, you're really going to get great modulation, light lever pull, which is nice, because if you think of a traditional spring, as it compresses, it gets harder, mm-hmm. right? So as you're pulling the lever, it actually gets hard. The conical or cone disc spring, once you get through that first initial piece, it actually gets lighter.
Ah.
So you get a light pull and it allows you to just have consistent feel. And like you said, that translates to just getting the power to the ground.
Okay, so you mentioned a smaller rear disc rotor, correct?
Correct, yeah.
So is it smaller than last year? Or?
Smaller than last year. So last year we had a 250 mil, mm-hmm. Which was the largest in class.
Yeah.
And what we felt was with the 250, it was just a little bit too much. Mm-hmm. So we've gone back to the 240 mil rear disc from braking. Which just gives a nice balance, good feel on the pedal, and better package.
Okay. Other changes. Suspension. Is suspension left relatively the same?
Relatively the same. We went away from the SFF last year, right?
Thank God.
So we went to the KYB spring fork, and that's been obviously revised. We also have a new updated triple clamp. So the lower triple clamp has been revised, again, to complement the 450 style chassis.
Yeah.
It's been revised a little lighter, and then so the fork settings and the spring rate have changed on the fork, going from a 5.0 to a 4.9.
Lighter.
Okay. And also on the front end, the master cylinder for the front brake has also been revised. That comes over from the KX450 as well.
Mm-hmm. You brought the chopstick levers over.
Oh yeah.
Well, is there anything else we need to touch on? Because I know that Sleater and Renee are itching to get
go.
On the bike.
Well, we got the fat bar, of course.
Yeah,
that's new bar. For 21. So going to the Renthal fat bar away from the 7th, 8th. And again, that just changes up the cockpit feel,
mm-hmm.
Gets a little bit of comfort. And of course, with the Kawi, you have the ErgoFit technology. So you have four different positions on the front to place your handlebars, as well as two positions in the foot pegs.
Mm-hmm.
So your rider can really custom fit this bike, no matter what their skill level, their speed, you know, their body size, mm-hmm. they can custom fit this bike. And then with the new chassis, you get all the new bodywork. So This stuff will all bolt onto a 450 now. Nice flush transition. You can get right up to the gas tank. So yeah, all in all, pretty much every part of this bike has been revised and touched up, and we're excited to see what you guys think.
Air filter interchangeable with the 450?
Ooh, that one I don't think so. I think the airbox is a little different.
Okay. Well, hey guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to check back in a couple hours for the ride impression.